We go with the same roll we had.
Yeah, we'll roll from there.
Okay, you want to just use a 20-sided?
Yeah.
I'll start, right?
Hey, 3.
Not 20.
All right. Crit.
I will continue to play.
We start, right? Now we are.
This is a significantly worse hand than what I had. I'm going to mulligan.
Got it. I will keep.
I'm gonna mulligan. Man, it's a big change from the way.
It's a camera's fault.
Huh?
It's a camera's fault.
It is. It has to be. I mean, I drew a hand with like 3 one drops and 3 lands earlier.
I love how your math conveniently leaves out the bomb that you're going to hit me with on turn 4.
Yes, bombs. Not the worst hand ever. I'll keep mulligan.
Pass.
Pass.
Double necromancer and pass.
Swamp and pass. Just want to throw this out there. I hate it.
Swing for 2. All
right, down to 18.
Second main phase. We Dragonauts. And pass.
Let's go to the island. Final sort of beat. And
nice. Rubble belt 4. Electromancer can get +2 +0.
All right.
1 in the air and 4 on the ground.
I'll take 5, go to 13.
And pass.
Swamp. And play Muse Jam. I drop.
3, nice.
And I will.
Five on the ground.
So he's now a 7. He's a 7.
a 10 on the dice.
There it is.
Alright, then I'll put a plus 1 on the music. Right?
Second main phase, electrostatic field. We're casting this in a sorcery, one damage to each opponent.
Alright, pass. Bones, Defender 03, and I can surveil one. Let's put this one in the graveyard. Four mana, let's play the second easier.
Become prohibitive, sir.
Yeah, let's go ahead and pass.
Three defender. Pass turn.
Lifelink, when it's a battlefield, may exile target card from the graveyard. It's giving it an Electromancer. Whenever I surveil, if it's in my graveyard, I can pay 3 life, and I can return it to my hand.
Nice.
Mana for turn, let's play Guild Gate. Into combat. Swing with both of my drakes, 2-4 and 1-3.
Block the 2-4, only one.
Alright, there I go, not a damage. A pass.
Not a perfect round anymore.
This comeback mechanic, whenever I surveil, I can pay 3 life if it's in the graveyard. It goes back to my hand.
Okay.
It's decent.
Very interesting.
Okay. Can't see you, sir. And I'm surprised you didn't attack with your creatures, because I could have blocked one, but that would always fail with my creatures, and no matter which creature I
block. It's interesting. Swing for one in the air. Okay, we're supposed to know blockers. X is going to be 2. Let's deal 2 damage to him. I'm casting explosion. Now I will draw 2 cards.
Alright, so he's dead and I just take 3, right?
Yeah, 3 okay. In the air.
Down to 7.
And then whenever I cast instant or sorcery, like attack field deals one damage.
Nine six.
That'll be a pass.
All right, that was a good turn.
Thank you.
Very good turn.
Work out for me, okay.
Combat. Swing through the air.
Through the air, no blocks.
I didn't want to have to do this, but before it gets too scary, let's go ahead and ritual soup. Destroy all creatures with mana cost 3 or less. And I will. I don't know if that's the smartest idea.
Well, we'll find out in a minute, I guess.
I mean, those things probably would have killed me next turn if you got the right hand. So.
Drop a land for the turn. This Cyclops.
When you cast instant sorcery, you don't have Defender?
Yeah. Swing for 3.
Alright, down to 3.
Second main phase, Goblin Electromancer.
Yeah.
And pass turn.
Okay. Island and pass.
Blue. X is going to be 2. He cheapens it. We return 2 drakes to their owner's hand.
Got a little confident for a minute, but trying to hold on.
We knocked my dragon odds off. That was kind of.
Yeah, I probably. I don't know. I should have either saved that for the turn after or done it earlier. I don't know.
No. I
just kept drawing the lands after like turn 4. That ritual was a good turn, though.
That was really good. There's a lot of 3-drop creatures and. I was looking through, and green is pretty much the only color that has creatures above power of 3.
Yeah.
With any significance. I don't know.
I hope Dorn gets a win with those auto win cards to be cool. Yeah, when I got out the second drink, I was like, good, I can block pretty much anything. This dragon off came out.
Oh man, you stabbed me.
Learned that the hard way, way back in Innistrad.
Yeah.
Never underestimate the power of flying weenies.
Oh yeah, yeah.
They will.
Flyers are great and limited.
You're on the play.
Alright. Sounds
good. Presumably.
Yes. Yeah, I'll keep this.
I'll keep.
Go gate pass.
Pass.
Stop the barrier bones. Survive. I'm gonna keep that on top. Nice.
Ornery Goblin. Oh, okay. Pass.
Swamp.
Oh, should I do? I got so many plays right now we can do.
Token creature I control dies, it deals one damage to me and I draw a
card. Yeah. Nice.
Then I will pass. Yeah, I how it even triggers up itself.
What to do with that? I think the only right play is to swing for fences. Swing in for two.
Block with the barrier.
He'll deal one damage to it, and then planeswalk, and then two for combat.
So I lose one life. And draw a card.
Second main phase. Pass while adept.
Can we block?
Potentially.
Yeah.
Pass turn.
Alright. Swap. Blood operative.
I recognize that guy.
It says may exile, I'm not exiling him. And hired poisoner.
One on death touch.
It's gonna be a problem. Okay. Because swinging with the Reaper. 3-2. So, quick question. If I did block this with him, he would do the one damage before he done damage to him, right?
Correct. Okay. Yeah. So many things to do, and so little mana to do it with.
I'm okay.
One damage each creature you control, and your creatures can't block this turn.
Ooh, okay, so they vibe at him.
Yeah, it's basically striving.
So I get to, I take two damage, and I draw two. It's not a terrible trade-off.
It could be a lot worse.
Dude's never gonna gain your life, though.
But you're three.
Alright.
That's
14.
That life link has bothered me, so.
Yeah.
And pass, I guess.
Barrier bones. Survive one. Let's put in the graveyard. Let's pay three life to bring back the dude to my hand.
Jumpstart ability on this. I just can nuke the field again.
I can get one of my guys. But
the important one.
Yeah, yes. Definitely be worth it.
Okay.
matchup, I'm not gonna lie.
Oh man. Capture sphere, he taps and will not untap.
That's a good way to deal with him.
And they'll swing for two.
Sure. Kill him.
Yeah.
Got a 10.
And I'll pass.
Go ahead and get the lock it up.
Nice.
Swing in. 3-2.
So right now the one.
Lock.
Alright,
so the 1-3, so okay. I'll die.
Alright, main phase 2, play my good gate.
Result boar, he'll go up +2/+0. Let's go ahead and give him +1/+1 and haste.
So he is a 4/1?
Correct.
Okay.
And swing for 8.
Alright, in response to your requiring attackers. Flash and whisper agent. Sorry, civilian. Put that in the graveyard. And I block the goblin.
That's right.
And so I take 4.
Correct.
Down to 6. Oh, and it's a May ability, right? Oh, no, it's automatic. It has to do it. Alright, so I'm down to 9.
That's a 2-edged sword.
Draw a card, and then I'll take the 4, so I'm down to 5. I feel like I'm doing good, but bad at the same time.
I'm leading on life, but you've got board state. Well, you know. Pass turn.
Just gonna play now.
Actually, I know it's useless, but I still want to at least. Sorry. Okay, then 5/1. So fast.
I should be doing this all in main phase too. I just haven't played magic in a while. Go to combat, swing in 3. And then I'll pass.
That has become a problem. Master Sphere. Spirit. Move to combat. Level 3. Grab a trade.
First the trigger, I'm down to 4. Kill me with my own trigger, I'm really mad. And I will put the +1 on the Reaper.
Okay. Second main phase.
Alright, I keep getting down to one creature.
One more than I'm sitting on.
Go with Burial of Bones, Surveil, Graveyard.
Death is too good for him.
3 mana. Deathblade, as long as I Surveil, it has Death Touch, and whenever it deals damage, I draw a card.
Nice. Very nice.
I have a card to play, but I was scared to choose. I'm not going to do it. Swing it with 4. And I will pass. I just realized I cursed him.
Static field.
Oh, I'm glad I didn't play the other card.
Pass turn.
Now it's more of a race than anything.
War of attrition. The 2 needs a 4.
Okay. One of those catcher spheres I would have won. Crazy match.
I won the first game, lost the second one by one card. Yeah. I lost both games.
We Dragonauts?
Mm-hmm. Who'd you play? Him?
No.
Over there.
He has 2 life cards.
The first game. I could lock you down to 1 because I could jumpstart it.
Last turn.
Man, yeah, I was this serious. If I have one more, yeah, that's a boy. Any cards, because I just had to discard it to jumpstart. It's whatever.
So I can get my turn.
3 mana, sacrifice the locket to draw 2 cards.
Okay.
4 mana, capture Spirit of Dragonox. And
that's fair.
Yeah, swing it with us.
There we go.
This is what I was terrified of playing. Like, it would have been good if I played it earlier. With all the damage I was already doing to myself on here. And here are your capture spears.
Thank you, sir.
What was that? Oh, okay. I was confused. I was about to say, we still have 1 match.
Yeah, that gateway card slowed me down more than it's ever helped anything, so.
That was a really good match.
That one was good. I almost had a jumpstart card to drop you to 2.
I can tell you're looking at your banner for something.
The problem is you have to have a card to discard to trigger jumpstart, and
That midnight reaper card is nuts.
I love it. Is that the one that was letting you draw everything?
Mm-hmm. It's kind of scary, but it was good. It gave me a ton of advantage.
Yeah.
Especially as all circle a little bit.
I've got card draw in here. I've not seen it in two games, so.
Little shot.
It's so weird to think of like mana.
I'll go ahead and take the play.
I will keep this.
I'll keep.
I love that. Literally came with like
bass.
Swamp. Bare bones.
Okay. No. I'll take it.
Oh, I don't have to reveal that, do I? I've been revealing every time.
I don't know all these cards well enough to actually
keep it up.
Don't you know me this?
Here's some extra good cards.
Goblin.
Alright, pass. Play another swamp. Do another barrier. Graveyard it. Then wait your goblin. Minus two, minus two.
I'll kill him.
I can get in with nothing, so I pass.
That's a pass. I'm relying on that goblin quite a bit more than I probably should have.
It's a notion ring. Do it early this time. Surveil two, draw two cards, and I'll lose two.
These are two threes. I'll play maximize altitude.
Survey and then draw two?
Yes.
That is really nice.
Top, and then I'm going to go.
That's really nice.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome for a three card.
This one is now
that's a sorcery?
Yep.
I'm going to go ahead and copy it with expansion.
All right, so you lose two as well.
Yeah.
Well,
it is four left, right?
How are you copying it? Oh, I was looking at sorcery. Sorcery cost.
Yeah. No, that's the other version, so. Vay two. Okay, come back. Pass turn.
Yeah, I'm pretty good. Like, I love blue red. Like, whenever I play modern, it's storm. Then you step to, like, storm up and your modification. So I move to, like,
this. Couldn't pull out a lock.
No, I know.
My turn.
At the end of your turn, I'm going to have a radical idea. Draw two.
Okay.
Or draw a card. I'm sorry.
I'd say that'd be pretty nuts.
Two mana, two cards, that's fair, right?
Fane notion ring is good.
Draw. Nice.
Okay, 15. You're at how much left?
Oh! So about roll four, he's going to kick up to 3-3. Swing for three.
Got a 15.
And pass.
Swamp. Three mana. Let's play a second locket.
Three fire urchins is so great.
Three mana. Let's get out the reaper. Then I'll pass my turn.
Sure about that?
No, I'm not sure about any of my moves.
Understandably so.
I would like to be sure. No, this guy's been pretty great so far.
Mm-hmm.
Beacon Bolton for two.
Oh, wow. That's just a
four. Right. So I lose one.
And then I will swing for three.
Yeah, I'm blocking.
Yep. And I will pass.
I should probably slow down while I'm blocking.
What game is this, dude?
Yeah. Let's get out the Drake. Interesting. Four. Dark Art. Play down a Guild Gate. And one mana, poisoner, and pass. Send that he's a murderer.
I'll pay one, and also these are two, these both are 2/3 that can attack. I'll discard this crazy, flashback, give this guy flying, and have this a 3/3. You take one. 7. Swing for 5 in the air, and then 6 in the
ground. Smooth as I would like.
It still only wins a game for
2.
Death touch out of the way.
Good game, bro. That's fun.
Swing three.
Dude, I love it. Especially like
blocking
with
the barrier.
Okay. Idea,
barrier's doing what it's doing.
Pass turn.
Just like, it's basically flashback. We have to discard a card. Check that line to say. Yeah. They're like, okay, flashback's too unfair, so how can we fix that? Well, let's make flashback.
Let's go
better.
Swing one in the air.
Wait,
can't stop that.
Go ahead and play centipede. I really hope we don't go to 10.
Yeah, bounce a centipede.
Yeah, it's gonna happen.
And then the field hits it for 1.
13.
Big 1. So I'll put it back on top of discard. Gary's got it. Okay, I'll put it on top.
In response to all that, I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4. Messy one. Capture superior board.
Nice. Moving to combat. 2 for 1.
10 to 12.
Pass turn.
Alright. This is.
Let's
go and go to combat one in the air.
I literally use that too. I had a card so I could discard jumpstart and I first stack deal one. I got the turn left.
Let's get the centipede back out there.
Oh, he had 7 damage on field. I feel surprised, but he saw the play and I stuck
with the
end. He had the war box. And so you could put
Watcher in the mist.
It's not good.
Move a 2. We're back in any order, correct?
Yep. Graveyard or not in any order. They have to be in the same order.
Okay, okay.
Put them in the graveyard or keep them out there.
And the rest on the top of your library. And the rest on the top of your library in anyway.
Oh, it is in your library. Okay. Yeah, but you can also put them in the graveyard.
That's what I want. I don't want them in the graveyard, but I will if I have to get the other thing. And we'll hold past there.
Okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and get rid of that Watcher in the Mist.
Rude.
And I'll surveil too. Graveyard top. Play Barrier of Bones to surveil one, and I already saw what it was, so I'm gonna keep it up. I probably should have saved that. Let's swing one in the air. Okay, that's in the air. That's also in the trash, and I'll pass. Alright, I guess we should kind of rush this. We've got like 2 minutes.
Unfortunately. 1-3. Dragonauts.
I hate that card. I hate that card.
Pass turn.
Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Watcher, you missed. You can't have them, but I can. I'm in the graveyard.
Pass at the end of your turn. I'm going to return my boar to my hand.
That's not good.
Alright. Survey one, I believe. Yeah. Put it there. That'll deal 1 damage to you when I cast the instant.
That'll
to start my turn.
Yep.
Beacon Bolt. We're going to jumpstart Beacon Bolt to take out the Watcher. I believe it is 5 in my graveyard right now. And that goes into exile.
So he gets +2 plus up?
That is correct, and you'll take 1.
Down to 10.
Swing for 3 in the air.
Alright, let's unexplained disappearance. Go back to your hand. Circle 1. Alright. This is good enough. There you go.
Second. Main Ferris. Pass.
Alright, so now we're on turns. We just set this up and
this is turn 0.
Is it like 5 in between? Like 5
it is,
each?
Yep. So whose turn is it right now?
It's mine. Yes.
This is turn 0, and then we'll go 1, 2, 3, okay. 4, so I'll just put the 5.
As soon as I'm done.
Yep, so this is 0.
Alright, let's go ahead and swing in with both of those guys. The ones that are going to say 2.
1-3 is in the air, correct? Okay. I will block the centipede, 0-4 defender, and I'll hit the one in the air.
Well, let's go. Actually, down to 14.
Unless you got any trick before a damage step.
Nope. Go to main phase 2. First of all, so 3 mana slot, convert a mana cost 3 or less, or all. Basically everything but the draw.
Rude.
Very rude. And then I will pass. I hate drawing. I don't think I'm going to get to 14 damage, though.
Pass turn.
Turn 2. I think we know where this is going to go.
It counts as a draw at the end, right?
It doesn't. It's a draw if we go to turn five. Or in turns, it's a draw if we go to turn five.
Yeah.
Then let's go ahead and 1, 2, 3, 4, sack the locket, draw two cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, play another Drake, draw a card. Go ahead. And turn three.
Damage has already been spent.
So is turn five the last turn, or does it end as soon as it goes to turn five?
I think turn five is the last turn, I believe.
Okay. That makes sense. I guess we got five turns.
Yeah.
So I think our goal is to make sure the other person doesn't win.
Goes Halberdier. Mm-hmm. And then I'm going swing for one.
Just go ahead and block it.
I'll draw a card, survey one, and pump him by two. So. No, draw a card. Not survey one. Sorry, my bad. Draw a card.
Yeah, land for turn. Card seem to be so much better than what this. Alright, I'm turn four, so this is my last turn. Can I do 14 damage?
Can you do it?
Let's go ahead and use Drake.
You have three of those?
Yeah. Sure. Let's sack the locket and see what I can do with zero mana. Well, nothing. Go ahead.
Say, can I mill you? Target player draws.
Glimpse the Unthinkable.
Actually, I think I already spent my one where target player draws X cards, so technically it's in here.
Would have been neat. Not for me.
Not really. Well, yeah, I'd have to get you over what you have.
At least we know our decks aren't trash. Either that or they're both trash. So much flyers in this format, it seems like.
Say, I'm one mana short no matter how I slice it.
Okay, just call it.
Pass.
Alright, man. Good games.
Well done.
That was fun, regardless of how.
That was,
guys, better than a loss.
Oh, man. We went the distance that third round.
Yeah.